it's Thomas here. Today we're gonna be doing a quick review on Brightwell Aquatics Purit. If you're looking for a chemical media that can remove a wide range of contaminants that often find their way into our reef tanks, like heavy metals, phosphates, silicates, and more, while helping to keep the water crystal clear, odor-free, and raise your aquarium's ORP at the same time, then check out Brightwell's Purit. This is exactly the kind of product that I like to use as a safety net for my tank, so that's what I'm gonna be doing. It's gonna be taking care of that one right there. There are a number of ways that various contaminants make it into our reef tanks. Whether it's just a natural byproduct from the foods you're feeding or additives that you're dosing, or perhaps from forgetting to rinse your hands before feeding or moving a frag that fell off the rack, possibly even your RODI water has started to read a few TDS higher than normal and you didn't catch it right away. I mean, it could even be that wayward razor blade that you were working with in the tank and then you accidentally dropped and it kind of fell into the crevices of your rock work and then you gave up looking for it and now it's just rusting away in there. Chemical media can really help when it comes to removing these impurities that shouldn't be in the water. You really should go find that razor blade though. One of the easiest ways to cover a wide array of potential contaminants is by using a blend of carbon mixed with ion exchange and absorptive resins. Brightwell's Purit is just that, a next generation blend of carbon and resin beads aimed at making sure anything that shouldn't be in your reef aquarium finds its way out of the tank where it belongs, keeping your reef inhabitants comfortable and healthy by tackling issues like yellow pigments and discoloration in the water, heavy metals, ammonia, chlorine, silicates, and more, and can also raise the ORP of your aquarium. When you open up the jar, you'll notice the included 150 micron mesh bag. Add 100 milliliters of Purit for every 25 gallons of aquarium water into the mesh bag and rinse it under a stream of fresh water. Then add it to your filter, the rear chamber of your all-in-one aquarium, or your sump in a spot with steady, moderate flow. Alternatively, you can add it to a media reactor, which is personally how I would run it since it makes sure that the water is flowing directly through the media at a steady rate. Just make sure to keep the flow rate moderate. You don't want to fluidize the media, so if any of those granules are bouncing around, just dial the flow back until everything stops moving, and you're good to go. Purit can last up to 6 months when used in a particularly clean and well-cared-for reef tank, but most reefers will likely see it exhausting sooner than that, especially in applications where you're using Purit to solve a specific issue, like high silicates, yellow-tinged water, or to remove medication. So if you can imagine, you've never run any kind of chemical media, you add Purit to your tank, anything that's been hanging around this whole time that shouldn't be there, Purit's gonna be pulling it out really rapidly, so it's just not gonna last as long. But once you've got all those issues solved, whether it was silicates or anything else, if you continue to use Purit as a preventative measure, it's going to last longer for you. Speaking of which, I've always been a fan of running this type of chemical media in my reef tanks as a sort of safety net to catch anything that accidentally or unintentionally made it into the tank before it can cause any harm. Even I've done it. Sometimes you see a coral tipped over in your reef tank and you instinctively reach in to correct it. Then you realize you didn't wash your hands before you stuck your hands in the tank and you start thinking about all the things you've recently touched and whether or not anything on your hands could harm the tank. Or if you tend to have a mixed reef of corals like softies and SPS that are known to have issues with chemical warfare, having Purit as a part of your filtration can help mitigate that coral warfare by removing the irritants and toxins the corals release, keeping the peace, so to speak, so your corals can continue to grow and look their best regardless of who their neighbors are. Now with all that said, before you add Purit or any other carbon type media to your tank, you will definitely want to check out Ryan and Randy's top 22 fails with filter media. Have a look right here. Super important. I have seen many reefers make more than a handful of these mistakes, number 6 for sure. So yeah, save yourself the hassle and just learn from all the mistakes that everybody else has made. Then you don't have to make them.